birthday and bravissima.
Happy birthday. I better get a hug when I get off this thing, okay?
Glad to be here, so thanks for having me. Happy birthday, by the way.
Well, first in order, happy birthday, Pat.
Happy birthday.
Thank you, and happy and healthy birthday, Pat.
Yes.
May you have many, many more.
When I became a musician is when I picked up the violin, but when I became an artist was when I started jamming with Steve. We met and started playing swing music, and that really turned the tide of things officially, and so Steve's been a big part of that.
So, Patrick, when was the first time you were out here?
First time I was out here, it was after my first time at Sweet Smell. So, I'm going to say 21. Maybe, yeah.
We went to your first
show
at the Tower.
You were there?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Was that about that time? It was right about that. It was like 2021. So the way I got started was I was jamming at kind of Latino arts parties. They started, I don't know how they found me, but jamming somewhere. So they said, hey, why don't you come play these parties? So I started meeting people in the arts, particularly like Chicano, Latino arts, and they wanted to sponsor me for a concert. And I first told them, like, no way, you know. A check later, they convinced me to do it. So I was like, oh, you're talking pay? And I barely even have a car. So that's not too bad. But anyway, I kind of got everything off. I went to Sweet Smell my first time. Cerro Negro drove me up, like, in the middle of the night. It was pretty awesome. So, but yeah, no, being here has been definitely, I was just thinking about it all the times I've been here. And so, glad to be here. So, thanks for having me. Happy birthday, by the way. Okay, so let's warm up really quick. I want to tell a quick little thing. On Wednesday night at about 8 o'clock, a cat was hanging in between my fence. In between the wood part, little crack, its leg was stuck. And it was hanging upside down and kind of crying and trying to lift up. And I was like, oh, he's going to break his leg, you know. And so I ran over to go help the kitty. I recognized it was the neighbor's cat. And I thought, well, he knows me. So I went to go help him up. But he was in full stiff, angry mode and found out it wasn't the neighbor's cat. And the cat bit me right through my thumb, went to my nail. So I didn't know anything about cat bites, feral cat bites, so I was like, oh, I'll just wash it and be okay. Yeah. And then I started asking around, and people said you need to go to ER immediately. So I went to ER and took a bunch of rabies shots, maybe 12 rabies shots. Worst. They, like, stick it right into the wound, the long old needle. I was literally kicking. And a bunch of antibiotic shots, and I went back to ER today to get my second round. So my thumb is still throbbing like heck, but I'm going to hold the bow like this, so don't judge me if I don't sound super great. But we're here. All right. Let's just warm up with a little blues. Thank you.
Thank you much.
Thank you.
Can we do Tijuana?
Sure.
Yeah. So it's two measures, G7, two measures, D minor.
All right. This is a little tune that I wrote called Tijuana, and it's about when I was at Fresno State, and right about that time of jamming with Cero Negro, there was a couple other guy I met named Neo Vang, who became a friend of mine, and we started hanging out and jamming, and anyway, we got our first gig, like a first real, like, where we thought we were going to be famous type gig. You know, we made it. It was like Patio Cafe at Fig Garden. I was like, I'd never been north of Shields, and I was like, wow, it's so fancy over here. And from there, we got into San Diego. I don't remember where we were playing, but some random place. And so afterwards, we were like, let's go get some food. Everything's closed. And I wasn't 21 yet. I was 20. And so I said, I told Neil, why don't we go to Tijuana and get some tacos? 2 a.m, right? Seems like a great time to go to Tijuana. And so we go to Tijuana, leave our instruments in the car at the border, and we're walking over, and I said, let's get some real tacos up. I don't want these tourist tacos. So we get a taxi, and he takes us into Tijuana, like deep into Tijuana. And that's where we're going to start this story. This is a little soundtrack of going through Tijuana and getting tacos. So the next part, we had some tacos, so some really good ones, and we're in like deep TJ, so we're right way past any tourists, so there happens to be right outside, usually where you find tacos, you're going to find a bar, so there would happen to be a bar right next to us, and it said, unlimited drinks, you know, I don't know, $15 or something, and I couldn't drink in San Diego. Because I was 20, so I was frustrated looking at Neo, you know, having like a delicious beer, and I was like, can't drink. And you know, no. Now I'd be like, don't do it. But at 20, I was like, I have to. And so I gave the guy $15. We went in, and it was all you can drink, but it was like the worst alcohol you've ever tasted. But I didn't care because I was like 20, just give it to me. So I'm like slamming drinks, and that's where we're at now.
Thank you.
Does it sound like you're in a bar taking shots? I don't know. So it's about 6 a.m. and we get in our taxi and we're crossing back over. And we get to the car. Not only we can't drive anywhere because we're totally plastered, but we didn't think to get a hotel or any place to stay, so we sleep in our car right there. This is what that sounds like. So, yeah, so that was another song that I wrote called Mojave leading up to that, which is, yes, we drove my little Geo Metrics through the Mojave Desert, and my car died, and we ended up playing for Spanish tourists right in the middle, and we were broke, so they gave us some money to fix my car. And yeah, that was leading up to that. But I don't know we don't know that song, but yes, Mojave is leading up to that. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you much. And of course, we used to do this one a lot. All of me.
Oh, yeah.
Because I love the way he plays swing. Take all of me. Well, can't you see I'm no good without you? Take my arms, I'll never use them. Take my lips, I want to lose them. Your goodbye left me with eyes. Without you. Now you took the part that once was my heart. So why not take all of me? Yeah, I know how to play it.
So I start on the note A.
That's where it starts on the G, G, A.
All right, this was a request I got from from Pat Wolk. So this is for her. So I recorded this, filmed a video for this in West Africa. I was supporting an organization called West African Vocational Schools. They asked me to go and sort of, I don't know, do a music video. But they didn't give me any direction, just to sort of, you know, help expose the name of Guinea-Bissau and what they're doing, et cetera, et cetera. So I went over there. I thought I was going to do like this African dance song, which I still may sometime. But I went over there and was like, just like a really humbling experience. And so what was cool about over there, they'd never seen a violin before, where many of the places where I was at, well, almost everywhere. And so the kids were just crowding me, like curious about instruments. And it's a very live music culture, you know. As you know, there's like one single national radio, but most households don't have a radio. They might listen to it in the city center. Everybody gathers around for, like, you know, war issues or something of that going on. But in general, there's not a lot of music and that's on radio, but there's a ton of music live. So what was cool about it was just that live instruments were just part of daily life. And so there was no weirdness factor. Sometimes I get here with the kids, their only relationship with music is YouTube or Spotify. They don't know how to relate to actual instruments. I don't know if you find that ever, Steve. So yeah, they get into it, but it's always a sort of wall up. Whereas in Africa, there's just no wall. Instrumentally, they wanted to grab it, touch it, you know, feel what this was. So anyway, it was a cool experience. And just a really quick, so I don't go too long, I was trying to match their music style, and it was pretty hard. But what worked was Irish music. When I played Irish music, it matched their timing signature down to a T, which was pretty cool. Anyway, okay, sidetrack there, but here's Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Very good. Very good. Keep deep. You need to know that.
Okay, got it. Yeah, yeah.
I hear you, man. I hear you. So, I think we should probably do one last tune and call it a night. What do you guys think? What? Oh, yes. Oh, you got it. Two more, she says? Okay, over the rainbow then.
Okay.
Let's see.
So this song was recorded this version with Steve at the Aubrey Library. Have we done it before, really?
I think we did it once before.
It wasn't like something set in stone, so...
No, it wasn't set in stone.
We did it in E flat, which is sort of like a bluesy R&B key, and recorded it, and for a good, like, while, and even still every once in a while, this recording... Is it up on the internet anywhere?
I'm not sure if it is.
I don't know, but I get hit up from people everywhere about this particular recording. So just a random night in Aubrey that recorded. So here's
random
a little...
Random night in Aubrey playing a tune.
Playing a tune. So here's Steve. Here's
right.
Somewhere the Rainbow.
Yeah, you got it. In a lullaby, somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then? Someday I'll wish upon a star and wake up where the clouds are far behind me. Where troubles melt like lemon drops, away above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh why can't I? Thank you. fish upon a stone. Wake up where the clouds are far behind you. Where troubles melt like lemon drops, away above the chimney tops, that's where you'll find me. Somewhere over the rainbow, bluebirds fly. Birds fly over the rainbow. Why then, oh why can't I?
Thank you.
Thank you very much. Y'all have a great evening. I think that'll do us for tonight.
Happy birthday.
Happy birthday.